So in the previous lesson, we discussed about the illustration of limit theorems. So this time, we're going to discuss limits of polynomial, rational, and radical functions. So for theorem number one, let's see k and l and m be real numbers, and let f of x and g of x be function defined on some open interval containing c, except possibly at c. So for number one, if limit of f of x as x approaches to c exists, then it is unique. That is, if limit of f of x as x approaches to c is equal to l, and the limit of f of x as x approaches to c is equal to m, then we can say that l is equal to m. For number two, so the limit of c as x approaches to c is equal to c. So any number, no, kung kahit anong constant yung nakalagay dito, that is the limit. And number three, so the limit of x as x approaches to c is equal to c. So dito naman sa number three, so any number kung saan nag-a-approach yung x natin, so yung magiging sagot natin. And for number four, suppose the limit of f of x as x approaches to c is equal to l, and the limit of g of x as x approaches to c is equal to m, we have the different theorems. So for constant multiple theorem, if the limit of k times g of x as x approaches to c is equal to k times m. So ito yung nilalagay natin yung constant natin sa unahan ng limit natin, and then imumultiply natin sa limit ng g of x. Okay, for addition theorem, the limit of f of x plus minus g of x as x approaches to c is equal to l plus minus m. So dito, sinusunod natin kung anong operation yung ginagamit. So kung addition, so addition din yung gagamitin natin. Kung subtraction, subtraction din yung gagamitin. Next is the multiplication theorem. So the limit of f of x times g of x as x approaches to c is equal to the product of l and m, or l times m. For the division, so the limit of f of x over g of x as x approaches to c is equal to l over m. So define natin dito, no, suppose that this one is equal to l, so the limit of f of x is equal to l, and the limit of g of x is equal to m as x approaches to c. And take note, class, na kailangan yung g of x natin or yung m natin ay dapat hindi siya mag-equal sa 0, kasi magiging undefined yung sagot natin. And for the next one, the power theorem, so the limit of f of x raised to p, so as x approaches to c, is equal to l raised to p. So ang gagawin muna, kunin muna natin yung limit nitong f of x, saka natin erase sa p. So, and then, for p, a positive integer. And last, the root and radical theorem. So, the limit of the nth root of f of x as x approaches to c is equal to the nth root of l for positive integers n, and provided that l is greater than 0 when n is even. So, dapat kapag even yung nth root natin dito, dapat greater than 0 yung nasa loob ng radical sign natin. So ito ay i-review natin, gagamitin natin, no? So in this lesson, we will show how these limit theorems are used in evaluating algebraic expression, or algebraic function rather. So particularly, we will illustrate how to use them to evaluate the limits of polynomial, rational, and radical functions. So we start with evaluating the limits of polynomial function. So for number one, so determine the limit of 2x plus 1 as x approaches to 1. So kapag ganito, class, so i-apply natin yung natutunan nating mga theorem. So first, Okay, so may nakita tayong operation na addition. So gagamitin natin yung addition. So paghihiwalayin natin ito. So the limit of 2x as x approaches to 1 plus the limit of 1 as x approaches to 1. So we all know na yung constant multiple, di ba? Yung constant multiple natin ay ginagawa, yung constant natin ay ilalabas o ilalagay natin sa unahan ng limit. And then ito, constant na ito. So ito yung limit of c as x approaches to c. So any number dito, yan na yung sagot. Yun na yung limit natin. So ang mangyayari, ilagay natin yung 2 sa unahan ng limit natin. And then ito, makukuha na natin yung sagot. So 2 times, since ito yung x, di ba kapag may variable x tayo dito, so any number yung nandito kung saan nag-approach yung x natin, so yun ang sagot. So that will become 2 times itong 1 nakuha dito sa limit of x as x approaches to 1. So again, itong x ay nakuha dito, di ba? So that is 2 times 1 plus, and then ito ay constant, so gamit yung constant natin, so that is 1. So 2 times 1, the answer is 2. Plus 1, the answer is 3. So, the limit of 2x plus 1 as x approaches to 1 is equal to 3. Another example. So, determine the limit of 2x cubed minus 4x squared plus 1. So, meron tayong dalawang operation, subtraction and addition. So, paghihiwalayin muna natin sila and then kunin natin yung limit ng bawat isa. So, the limit of 2x cubed as x approaches to negative 1. So, sundan natin yung operation. So, minus the limit of 4x squared as x approaches to negative 1 plus the limit of 1 as x approaches to negative 1. So, next, since meron tayong constant dito, ilalagay natin sa unahan. Ganun din yung 4. Ilalagay natin sa unahan ng limit natin. So that will become 2 times the limit of x cubed as x approaches to negative 1 minus 4 times the limit of x squared as x approaches to negative 1 plus the limit of 1 as x approaches to negative 1. So since ito class, gagamitin natin, di ba, yung the constant multiple. So kunin natin yon. So anong sagot natin dito? So yung x natin, papalitan natin nung value ng x dito natin o yung x kung saan lumalapit, and that is negative 1. So negative 1 cubed minus 4, ganun din yung proseso dito. Negative 1 squared plus 1 since constant ito. So negative 1 times negative 1 times negative 1, still negative kapag add yung exponent natin. So negative pa rin yun. So negative 1 times 2, that is negative 2. So ito, negative 1 squared, that is positive. Positive 1 times negative 4, that is negative 4, plus 1. So negative 2 minus 4, that is negative 6, plus 1, the answer is negative 5. So another example. So determine the limit of 3x to the 4th power minus 2x minus 1. So from the theorem na present kanina, so as x approaches to 0, so, ang gagawin natin, so, mauna natin by using the addition, no, theorem, kasi ang operation natin is subtraction. So, gagamitin natin yon, maghihiwalayin natin. So, the limit of 3x to the 4th power as x approaches to 0 minus the limit of 2x as x approaches to 0 minus the limit of 1 as x approaches to 0. So, yung mga constant, ilagay natin sa unahan ng limit. So, ganun din dito yung 2, ilagay natin sa unahan. So, that will become 3 times the limit of x to the 4th power as x approaches to 0 minus 2 times the limit of x as x approaches to 0 minus the limit of 1 as x approaches to 0. So, dito 3, tapos meron tayong power kasi dito. So, ilalagay natin yung 0 dyan. So, 3 times 0 to the 4th power minus, so ito 0 na kasi x na lang, di ba? So, 2 times 0 minus 1. So, ito any number naman. Kapag minultiply natin sa 0, 0 pa rin. So, 0 minus 0 minus 1, the answer is negative 1. Okay, for example number 4, evaluate the limit of 1 over x. So this time sa example number 4, no, we're going to evaluate rationale, no, as x approaches to negative 1. So we will now apply the limit theorems in evaluating rational function. So in evaluating the limits of such function, recall from theorem 1, so the division rule and all the rules stated in theorem 1 which have been useful in evaluating limits of polynomial functions such as the addition and product rule. So kagaya nga itong nakikita nyo sa example number 4. So evaluate the limit of 1 over x as x approaches to 1. So first, note that the limit of x is equal to 1 since the limit of the denominator is non-zero. So kapag sinubstitute natin yung x dito, di ba, sa denominator natin, so hindi magsi-zero yan. So we can apply the division rule. So thus, so kunin natin yung limit, okay, by using the division rule. So the limit of 1 as x approaches to 1, so yan ang maging numerator natin. Sa denominator naman natin, the limit of x as x approaches to 1. So using the constant, no, constant multiple, so this is ano, constant lang. So the answer for numerator is 1, no? Same din dito, so 1 din. So 1 divide 1, the answer is 1. Another example, so evaluate the limit of x over x plus 1 as x approaches to 2. So first, we're going to check, no, yung limit ng polynomial natin sa denominator kung ito ay ba ay mag-zero. Kapag hindi siya nag-zero, so ibig sabihin, we can use the division rule. So since the limit of the denominator, kapag sinubstitute natin yung 2 dito sa x, the answer is 3. And that is, yung limit ng denominator natin is not zero, so we can apply the division rule. Kagaya ng example number 4 sa previous example natin. So, ang gagawin natin, of course, let's try to evaluate muna yung denominator para ma-check talaga natin, no? So, evaluate natin yung limit ng denominator natin. So, paghihiwalayin since using the addition rule, so the limit of x as x approaches to 2 plus the limit of 1 as x approaches to 2. So dito, kapag x yung nandito, any value yung nandyan, that will be the answer. So 2 plus 1, ito constant. So 2 plus 1 is 3. So yung denominator natin dito ay 3. So balik tayo dito. So the limit of x as x approaches to 2 over 3. So, the limit of x as x approaches to 2. So, since x yung nandyan, so, di ba, kung x yung nandito, any number na nandito, yun yung limit natin. So, the answer sa numerator natin ay 2. So, the final answer is 2 over 3. So, another example. So, evaluate the limit of x minus 3, the quantity of x minus 3 times the quantity of x squared minus 2 all over x squared plus 1. So, same kanina, no? Evaluate muna natin. I-check natin yung limit ng denominator natin. Na kapag sinubstitute natin yung 1 or by applying the theorem, kailangan di siya mag-zero. So, kapag chinek natin yung 1, so 1 squared plus 1, so hindi siya 0. So, the answer is 2. So, tingnan natin. Unahin natin yung denominator natin. So, the limit of x squared as x approaches to 1 plus the limit of 1 as x approaches to 1 by power theorem. So, ito naman, since x pala to, okay, so x yun nandito, isa-substitute lang natin yung 1 dun sa x natin, and 1 squared plus, ito ay constant, plus 1, so 1 squared still 1 yun. So, 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. So, yung denominator natin dito ay 2. So, ito na lang ang gagawin natin, yung nasa numerator natin. So, the limit of x minus 3 times, the limit of x minus 3 as x approaches to 1 times the limit of x squared minus 2 as x approaches to 1 all over 2. Kasi kinuha na natin yung denominator natin. So, isa-isahin natin ito kasi meron tayong subtraction dito. So, paghiwalayin natin. So the limit of x as x approaches to 1 minus the limit of 3 as x approaches to 1 times the limit of x squared as x approaches to 1 minus the limit of 2 as x approaches to 1. So apply lang natin yung theorem at yung mga rule sa theorem number 1. So the limit of x, so ito ay 1, no? So 1, ito constant, so 1 minus 3. So ang 1 is substitute lang natin dito sa x, so 1 squared, that is 1 squared minus constant ito, so this is 2. So 1 minus 3, that is 2, negative 2, and 1 squared is still 1, 1 minus 2 is negative 1. So negative 2 times negative 1, that is positive 2. So 2 divide 2, the answer is 1. Okay, so that will be the limit of the quantity of x minus 3 times x squared minus 2 as x all over x squared plus 1 as x approaches to 1. So the answer is 1. Next. Okay, so we're going to proceed to theorem number 2. So theorem number 2, let f be a polynomial of the form. So naalala natin, this is the polynomial function, no? So f of x is equal to a n times x raised to n plus a n minus 1 times x raised to n minus 1 plus a n minus 2 times x raised to n minus 2 plus up to a sub 1 x plus a sub 0. So from here, so if c is a real number, then the limit of f of x as x approaches to c is equal to f of c. So titingnan natin, no? Parang kapag kukunin daw natin yung limit nito ay equal lang dun sa pagkuha pag nag-evaluate tayo ng function. Kung saan isi-substitute lang natin yung value ng c doon sa mga x natin. So we are going to prove that, let's say, be any real number. Remember that a polynomial is defined at any real number. So, f of c is equal to, kagaya nito dito. So, kasi yung f of x daw is equal dyan. So, same sila. So, ipro-prove natin ngayon. So, now, applying the limit theorems in evaluating the limit of f of x as x approaches to c. So, gamit ito class, gamitin natin ng theorem kung talagang equal ba yung limit of f of x as x approaches to c dito sa f of c natin. Okay, so the limit of f of x as x approaches to c. So, ito yung value natin. So, paghihiwalayin natin kasi meron tayong addition. So, paghihiwalayin natin. So, the limit of a n times x raised to n as x approaches to c plus the limit of a n minus 1 times x raised to n minus 1 as x approaches to c plus the limit of a n minus 2 times x raised to n minus 2 as x approaches to c plus up to the limit of a 1 x as x approaches to c or plus the limit of a 0 or a sub 0 as x approaches to c. So after that, ilalagay natin sa unahan, no? Ito, this will be the constant. Constant ito, ilalagay natin sa unahan. So, ganun din yung a n minus 1, ilagay natin sa unahan. Yung a n minus 2, and then same din dito. No? Yung a sub 1, ilagay natin sa unahan. And then after that, so ano na lang maiiwan? So, since yung x natin, di ba sa, ano natin, doon sa theorem number 1. So, yung x na to, kapag x na lang nandito, papalitan natin ng c. Tama? So, ipapalit natin yung c. So, maging a sub n c raised to n. Plus, ganun din dito, papalitan natin ng c. A n minus 1 times c raised to n minus 1 up to a sub 0. So, yung f, the limit of f of x as x approaches to c, na ito yung sagot, ay equal dito sa f of c natin. So, therefore, we can prove na masasabi natin na yung limit of f of x as x approaches to c is equal to f of c. So, paano gagawin? Ibig sabihin, instead na kunin natin yung yung limit by applying the rule sa theorem number 1 natin, so pwede pala na i-substitute na lang natin yung value ng c, yung parang nag-i-evaluate lang tayo ng functions. So, let's try example number 7 or example number 1 with this theorem number 3. So, by applying the theorem number 2 rather pala, no? Evaluate the limit of 2x cubed minus 4x squared plus 1 as x approaches to negative 1. So, note first that our function is f of x is equal to 2x cubed minus 4x squared plus 1. So, ano yung x natin dito? So, yung computing for the value of f at x is equal to negative 1, we get, so we're going to substitute. So, yung x natin, papalitan lang natin ng negative 1. So, same dito. Lahat ng x, papalitan ng negative 1. So, 2 times negative 1 cubed minus 4 times negative 1 squared plus 1. So, negative 1 cube, since add ito, so still negative 1 pa rin. So, negative 1 squared, this is even, so positive yan. So, 2 times negative 1, that is negative 2. Negative 4 times 1 is negative 4 plus 1. So, negative 2 minus 4 plus 1, the answer is negative 5. So, itong example na to ay binigay din kanina by applying the yung theorem number 1 natin. So, kung babalikan natin, pareho sila ng sagot. So, therefore, we can say that the limit of f of x as x approaches to c is equal to f of c. So, kasi equal sila eh, di ba? So, may mga case na ganun, na they are equal. Next. Okay, for theorem 3, let h be a rational number function of the form 8 of x is equal to f of x over g of x, where f and g are polynomial function. If c is a real number and g of c is not equal to 0. So, kailangan class yung titingnan natin dito that our g of x or yung g of c dapat not equal to 0. Kasi class, pag equal to 0 yung denominator natin, undefined yung magiging sagot natin dyan. So, we can prove that from theorem number 2, the limit of g of c as x approaches to 1 is equal to g of c, which is non-zero by assumption. So, moreover, the limit of f of c as x approaches to c is equal to f of c. So, therefore, by the division rule of theorem 1, so, we can say that the limit of f of x over g of x as x approaches to c is equal to the limit of f of c as x approaches to c over the limit of g of c as x approaches to c. And that is equal to f of c over g of c. So, to summarize, ang gagawin lang, evaluate lang natin yung numerator natin and denominator by substituting kung ano man yung value ng c. Okay, so let's try another example. So, evaluate the limit of 1 minus 5x as all over 1 plus 3x squared plus 4x to the 4th. So, as x approaches to 1. So, since the denominator, so ang una kasi natin i-check kapag sinubstitute natin si 1 dito sa denominator, kailangan hindi siya mag-equal sa 0. So, since the denominator is not 0, when evaluated at x is equal to 1, so we're going to apply theorem number 3. Okay, so kanina yung kakadiscuss lang natin. So, by theorem number 3, so ano bang ginagawa ng theorem number 3? So, yung value natin dito, yung c natin, yan yung isasubstitute natin sa lahat ng value ng x para mag-i-evaluate na lang tayo ng functions. So, sa lahat ng value ng x, papalitan natin ng positive 1. So, that is 1 minus 5 times 1 all over 1 plus 3 times 1 squared plus 4 times 1 to the 4th power. So, 1 minus 5 times 1, that is negative 4. Bakit? So 5 times 1 is 5. So 1 minus 5, that is negative 4. Dito naman, 1 squared is still 1. So 3 times 1, that is 3. Plus 1 to the 4th still 1. 1 times 4 is 4. So 4 plus 3 plus 1, that is 8. So, and then pwede pa natin i-lowest term to. O i-reduce natin negative 4 over 8. And that is negative 1 half. So next, we will now evaluate the limits of radical function. So using the limit theorems. So yung radical functions naman ang bigyan natin ng example. So for example, number 9. So evaluate the limit of this square root of x as x approaches to 1. So by applying the theorem, so theorem number 3 and theorem number 2 and 1 also. So ano yung pwede natin doon sa root and radical theorem? Anong sinasabi doon? So ang sabi doon that the limit of x, so as x approaches to 1, ay dapat greater than si 0 yung value ng x natin. So using the radical and root theorem, so we can apply that. Since pag sinubstitute naman natin yung 1 dito sa x natin ay greater than 0, so pwede natin gamitin yung radical and root rule. So that's the square root of the limit of x as x approaches to 1. So since x yung nandito, ano yung magiging limit natin? So 1. So the square root of 1, the answer is 1. Next. For example, number 10, so evaluate the limit of the square root of x plus 4 as x approaches to 0. So first, tingnan natin no, yung magiging, kapag sinubstitute natin yung x dito sa loob, kailangan greater than 0 kasi even number yung nth root natin. So kailangan greater than 0. So pag sinubstitute yung x, that is 0 plus 4, and 4 is greater than 0. Hence, by the radical and root rule, pwede natin i-apply yon. So, that is the square root of the limit of x plus 4 as x approaches to 0. So, we all know na meron tayong operation na addition dito. So, pwede natin paghiwalayin yan. Or, pwede na i-substitute natin yung 0. So, let's see. So, if we're going to substitute dyan yung 0, so that is 0 plus 4. So, maging constant na yung 4 dyan. So, that will, ang maiwan na lang is 4, no? Kung sisasubstitute natin yung 0 dito, so that is 0 plus 4, so 4 na lang. The limit of 4 as x approaches to 0 is 4. So, square root of 4, the answer is positive 2. Another example. So, since the index of the radical sign is add, so we do not have to worry kung ang sagot natin dito ay negative sign. Okay, so hindi tayo mag-alala kung ang sa loob ng radical sign natin ay negative kasi add number yung nth root natin. So, or yung index natin pala, no? Yung tawag natin dito, yung index natin. So, okay lang yan kung negative yung makuha natin sa loob. Wag lang kapag even, kasi kapag even dapat greater than 0. So, by applying our theorem, so the cube root of the limit of x squared plus 3x minus 6 as x approaches to negative 2. So, substitute natin si negative 2 dito sa x natin. So, that is negative 2 squared, that is, kung papalitan kasi natin to ng x, ay yung x natin ng negative 2, that is negative 2 times negative 2, that is positive 4. Then, papalit natin yung negative 2 dito sa x, 3 times negative 2, that is negative 6. And then, ito naman, si negative 6, so copy lang natin. So, that is 4 minus 6 minus 6. 4 minus 6 is negative 2. Negative 2 minus 6 is negative 8. And cube root of negative 8, the answer is negative 2. So, walang problema, no? Kung negative man yung nasa loob ng radical sign natin. Kasi yung index natin ay add number. So, last example. So, evaluate the limit of the square root of 2x plus 5 all over 1 minus 3x. So, as x approaches to 2. So, first, Note that the limit of 1 minus 3x, kasi may rational tayo, tapos dito meron pang radical sa numerator. So, doble-doble, no? Ang gagawin. So, ang gagawin nyo muna, i-check nyo muna yung denominator natin. Baka mamaya mag-equal sa 0 kapag sinubstitute natin yung 2 dyan. So, and then of course, kapag nilagay natin, hindi naman siya mag-equal sa 0. And then yung 2, kapag sinubstitute natin dito sa loob, hindi rin siya magne-negative. So, greater than 0 pa rin. Kasi even number yung index natin. So, therefore, we can process this limit. Itong given natin. So, the limit of the square root of 2x plus 5. So, as x approaches to 2, that is our numerator. And the limit of 1 minus 3x as x approaches to 2. So, kung makikita natin yung numerator natin ay mayroon tayong radical sign pa dito. So, ang gagawin natin, so we're going to substitute na nung 2. No, 2 dito sa x natin. So, 2 times 2, that is 4 plus 5, the answer is 9. So, still we have a radical sign. So, the square root of 9. And then, yung denominator natin kasi, kapag sinubstitute na natin dito, so 2 times, 1 minus 3 times 2, so 3 times 2 is 6, so 1 minus 6, that is negative 5. Kaya negative 5 yung denominator natin. So square root of 9, that is 3, all over negative 5, so the final answer is negative 3 over 5. So I hope natutunan nyo how to process the limit of the function ng polynomial, radical, and rational functions.
Thank you for watching this video. I hope you learned something. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell button para updated kayo for more video tutorial. This is your guide in learning your math lesson, your WowMath channel.